Vancouver today with some of the members from UCA. Guys, thank you for meeting me here.
Awesome, thank you.
I'm assuming that the name UCA came up with because Venezuelans
for, is that
correct?
Is that what it is?
That's what we'll take.
Yeah.
No. We didn't know that, which is pretty cool. I thought that was neat. Actually, our base pair found that online. Somebody had asked him what UCA meant. But somebody had said a root.
So he went online for now,
but actually, we were coming up for Valley. I think it was really simple to find names we really loved. But they were taken. I had this really cool, aggressive fish. And he trusted me, he didn't like it. He would bite people, and it was awesome. And yeah, it was really neat. So when we're coming up with names, all of a sudden, we're like, you know, Yuka's a great name.
Yeah.
It kind of represented our music. It was something that was aggressive, but it was graceful, and it was powerful, and it was beautiful. At the same time, when you heard the name, you wouldn't forget it.
So,
from Miami, right? I'm from Miami, and the rest of the band's from Miami.
Okay.
But obviously, Miami is much cooler, so.
Yeah.
The farther east you go, the people just stop caring. So I thought Miami was bad, but I mean, people in Miami don't even care about that.
Well,
yeah,
I'm in White Rock, so I care about him.
There you go.
I care about White Rock.
I know that you guys have experience with a band called
Yes.
They're awesome. Yeah.
Hilarious guys.
Yeah.
Very
cool.
I know you just done some stuff, actually. I saw that. Yeah. They're hilarious. Seriously, they just make you, you just feel like you're at a birthday party.
Oh, yeah.
Just
totally.
Just
like stuff they put on. Yeah. They're kind of out there. But I noticed you guys are out there too.
That's a great question, actually. That's like really a brilliant question. I think the answer to that question, I kind of said, if anybody can beat David Letterman, I'll show whether or not it's
okay.
But it was painful.
Yeah.
I can give that as a
example.
So, no, it was the whole concept behind the video was that one of the things that they asked us to do was to do a viral video announcing the region chosen from hundreds and hundreds of bands. So when you think of viral videos, usually they think of like mistakes that people capture, or they're humorous, or they're really dumb. It was one of the things that we realized that we were going to get a lot of kids that do something really stupid. And I'm up for it.
If you can pass around on some world's worst tattoo websites.
But it went viral though. I've done some pretty stupid things, that's for sure. I've done too many stupid things, actually. The great thing is that I've learned, so I do less stupid things now.
Really?
Not true.
No, I'm not as crazy as him.
I had a shower and I came out of Canada. It did. Give me a hug. I happened to not be wearing those clothes. And I'm not even having any care for love or respect to chase me.
Wait,
like,
no, but
I went to see last night and it was one of the
Disney
one,
right?
Really?
Yeah. The Peak Performance Project. Backtracking.
Sure.
What was your favorite part?
If there was a chance to meet with all of these instrumentalists, super cool people that were involved in the music scene locally and internationally too, and being able to connect with them, it's so hard to do that when you're not part of a project like that.
You guys have shared the same amazing.
Yeah.
I'm jealous. That would be amazing.
And also get a chance to, you know, get on stage and know who's coming on happy. We really feel blessed that you would pay to come see us perform. We don't feel like we deserve to be on stage. It's an honor for us to be here. So
yeah.
We definitely treat it that way.
Like even recently, this last September, we played with King Paul, and it was unbelievable. One of the coolest things about it was when I was in high school, like in my grade 12 year, we covered one of their songs, It Was Live, and it was cool to be on stage with a band that he covered back in high school. Like, that's when you were coming at that point in my life. That's when I was like, right? And going back to what happened, we had these glowing faces because we, like, that's, like you were saying, that would be it if I could play on stage like that.
No matter where you are in your career, you guys seem like you're gonna
stay down first. It's something that we definitely like get off the stage and we'll be in, you know, in the green room, we'll be proud of ourselves. I think it's something that people don't do enough. They're not proud of themselves now. Getting to be able to step on stage with Lifehouse, one line crush, like Kim Mitchell, that he is an icon in Canada. Like it is an honor to share the stage with those people. And it's exciting. It really helps to push us to be better musicians, better entertainers, better live show, to write better music. I mean, these people have been doing it for a long time, and there's a reason for that. So it's amazing how much you learn when you shut up and listen.
you say Canadian icons, you guys are known for the number of different regions.
Yeah, that's pretty cool, right?
How does that even happen?
There was a competition that they do, it's in like a worldwide international competition, that we were asked to be part of it to submit a song. So we submitted it about something. It was really neat for the judges, where everyone, our Robert Penn, and like, I mean, there was so many that like we just looked up to, that were just fantastic musicians. We thought this would be really cool to get their opinion on the song. And it came back that, you know, we got chosen to be the top 15 in the world.
Well, that was awesome. And just being able to perform for people from all over the world is cool enough. Then to get one of your songs chosen to be in a video game, that for me was just amazing. I'm a video game nerd, so for me it was really cool to see my song that we wrote and we're playing on in a video game that's been sold over the world.
I saw you guys playing Rock Band in one of your videos. Easier to play Rock Band when you already know your instrument?
Not even the slightest.
Oh, it is for me because I'm an avid video game player, so I put it on like super expert.
Super
expert.
And play it backwards
with
it
behind
your head. Exactly.
It's not, you know, like for the drums, there's only four pads and there's only a drum pad. It's tougher, so.
I find it actually easier. I don't play it often. I love the game. I think it's fantastic, but I have found it easier to play on use than actually.
Really?
Yeah, because it's weird how when you're used to actually following like throughout rehearsals, we're watching it following each other's tempo is fun. We know when we can hear it and feel it. And then also when you're playing a game and I don't have all the experience, I'm terrible. But also when you realize it's supposed to be going here, but it's not, and it's all about visually matching as you go. It's amazing how when I put her on mute, I can do it. But also when I was the song came, I'm like, wait a minute, it's not following the same structure as what I'm hearing. I'm thinking of doing a whole show with just Rock Band set up.
Yeah. On mute. So
it's just you gotta build it.
Just like clicking like
just clicking.
Wow. This 2011. I mean, 2010 was an incredible year for us. It was a packed year, an amazing year. We, you know, bands thought we were taking steps forward and we took leaps and bounds. And it was quite a cool thing to have this experience. So 2011 is not just being able to finish the record and to co-write and to actually push ourselves beyond what we've ever been pushed and to properly get, you know, the launch of you. We set huge goals for us in 2010 and we achieved that and more. So I can't wait for, you know, early January because we need to set the goals again. And it's so far looking like it's going to be another year. So we're really excited.
Seeing where even your iTunes sales come from, you know, you just pop online and it's like, oh my god, I didn't know that many people in the UK were buying our stuff. Or if that continues, then I can totally see us continuing up in the UK, and why not? It's just a matter of timing, and if we can get our all working on it,
I think in the short term, definitely the goal is getting the songs finished for the record, like you said, and then join us.
Yeah, we've watched it already.
I asked
every interview. Yeah. Right. You guys wearing any today?
Perfect. Sorry.
Wow.
Yeah.
Does it both match?
Yes.
They might have both black, but they don't match.
They don't match?
No.
Are they two different colors of black?
One's got a little stripe on the bottom, one doesn't.
Fair enough. And
is there
a reason they don't
match?
Because
he lives on his own.
I live on my own. I'm a bachelor. Whatever soccer or
whatever happened to find on the ground at the time.
Yeah.
Those are
going. I just admit I chose mine based on the fact that like these didn't have my dog's hair on them.
Okay.
And I was like, yeah, but that one.
See, there's always a method to choosing your song.
There is. Yeah.
Do you ever feel like you've chosen the wrong one?
Yes.
You're
still there. You ever put on like. Yeah, it's so funny because you put on like socks and I'll put on one that's new and then you put on one old and you're like, all the other, this sucks. You just feel like balance and I have no idea why and I think it's immense. But
it's true, I did that today. I bought new socks and I never wear matching.
What are you wearing today?
I am wearing Easy Tiger socks.
Nice.
And
Easy Tiger.
There's always a method. They always match in some way, but not the same.
I do have some socks that are bright pink, and they say I rock with a huge monkey on them. And the only thing is that when you cross your legs, which I tend to do quite a bit, and yeah, this pink monkey that says I rock. I mean, I'm confident in it, but I didn't want to embarrass myself.
Well, thank you guys very much.
Thank you.
Appreciate your time.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Okay.